Hello viewers, in this video I'll showing macro recorder system in Excel and how to get benefits from this. Excel macro recorder is a very useful tool in VBA. Using these features, you can record every task that you want to perform in Excel. And you don't have to be a programmer or know VBA code to write this. When you record a macro, Excel record all information about each step of perform in VBA system. After in record, then run this macro to repeat or playback by single commands. Recording steps include like typing any text or numbers, formatting cell rows or column, any commands on the ribbon or menus, or even importing data from external source. Let's suppose these are monthly unformatted cells data information that are input in whole month, and from here need to generate total sales volume and others information with good formatted report at the end of every week or month or any period. Now I showing this reporting system with macro recorder very easily. For this step, first access the developer tab on ribbon that provides access the macro commands, because this tab does not appear by default. So displaying the developer tab, go on file, then option, then customize ribbon, then checkbox on the developer tab and OK. Now developer tab are accessed for recording macro. Now go to developer code group. If you have not run macros before, you must need to change your macro security level for enabling which macros run and under what situation when you open a workbook. Here have four option. I using your second option and OK. You can also choose here two option before recording, absolute or relative reference. By default, Excel records macros in absolute mode. Absolute mode places the recorded steps exactly in the cell where it was recorded on the active cell. On the other hand, recorded with relative reference can perform the recorded task at different parts on the worksheet. Here I recording with absolute mode. So click here or click here this button. Now open macro dialog box. Here macro name text box type a name for macro identify. Name should be short but descriptive. If you record a lot of macros so that you can easily identify them. Monthly sales data. Optionally can use here shortcut key for run your macro quickly after record. You can use here control plus another key, but control plus shift plus another key are best for not overrides the Excel shortcut key. Shift plus M, another key. Now that's are important where this macro will store. In list C, different option for select where want to store the macro workbook. If store personal macro workbook, then workbook will available whenever you use macro workbook for every worksheet that are automatically saved in XLSTART folder. If store new workbook, then workbook you can run in any new workbooks created during the current session. If store this workbook, then workbook save in the current workbook file. Here I want to store personal macro workbook for access in everywhere. Optionally type in description of the macro here for easily identify them when use mini macro. Monthly sales report analysis and OK. So my recording job has started. First insert rows, column, merge here, type sales report, bold, increase font, change color, here also increase font size, bold, adjust column width, auto fit column width. Now sales amount count, quantity, multiplying rate, enter. Sales tax for sales amount into late 5%, enter. Sales commission for sales amount multiplying late 2% and total, enter. Now drag in down for all values. Here also add row, merge here, type total, total, sum, bold, increase font size. Now format currency, currency no decimal, dollar, and center. Here also apply conditional formatting. If value greater than $1,500 sales tax, then sale will be red color. So reporter completed. Now stop recording. If I want to see subtotal of brand name all keying by another macro, then recording macro, macro name type subtotal, shortcut key Ctrl Shift S, personal macro workbook, type here subtotal count and OK. So first sorting brand name, brand name. Now go to data, subtotal, select here brand name and checkbox brand name, quantity. That I want to see checkbox and OK. So subtotal also completed report. Now stop recording and save personal macro workbook. Save. If you store, select in another option in new workbook and this workbook. This file will save must be like save as, select destination and save as type, select here Excel macro enable workbook for macro enabling job. Personal macro workbook will automatically save in XLSTART folder. That finding search in run command like type here XLSTART or type this word for Windows 10. Okay. So this file has supported to all Excel same category file as a repeated task. Now I'm showing how to get benefits from this macro. I recorded here two report in macro recorder from raw data. Now apply these two macro in raw data as a repeat with a single command. So this is my raw data. Now apply for report generate, go developer tab, then macros. Now for sales report generated, run this macro. Sales report are generated very easily. Now I want to generate subtotal report from second macro. Go macro, then for subtotal report generate, run this macro. If you want to see what happening in recorder, see that in VB editor. Go macro. Then see here. See that here are coding generated for your all stable job. If you will learn a VB code, you can edit this code for any update whichever you want. So macro recorder is a very easy, accurate and time-saving job that apply to repeated task. Here I just showing sample of job, but you can do anything in macro recorder. So viewers, thanks for watching. Please like, share and comments and subscribe my channel for more views.